At least 44 people were killed following the attack on the Lobiriha Secondary School by the Allied Democratic Forces, or ADF, on Friday, 16th of June 2023. Most of the victims were students at the school, and on a tragic night, over six students were abducted. An event that turned out a page for the school, or maybe permanently. Mpondwe Secondary School in Lobiriha Town Council is about 2 kilometers away from the border with the Democratic Republic of Congo. On visiting the school premises yesterday, we discovered that the school is turning into a bush. The proprietors of the school are now unemployed and life is tough to their side, having lost their only source of income. Brenda Masika, the wife of the school director, Buletom Nelson, revealed that their standards of living are terrible given the fact that the school is no longer operational. She says that they cannot even afford basic needs.
For days, we are living in bad conditions. We no longer have the source of money to buy food, clothes, school fees for our children. We request governments come to our rescue.
Masika added that they are still traumatized by the attack, as some people accuse them of having collaborated with the ADF to kill the students.
Being collaborated with ADF come and kill the students.
According to the locals neighboring the school, Lobiriha Secondary School was very important to the community since it rendered education services to the people.
Our children used to learn from this school very well, but after the attack, the school closed. Even us, who could work small money, bringing the children on border, we lost our jobs.
Lieutenant Joe Walusimbi, the resident district commissioner for Kasese District, noted that since the unfortunate incident and some recent ones in the district, security operatives have attained tremendous achievement in pursuing ADF rebels, including killing several of them, plus arresting their senior commander, Njovu.
In the effort to capture one of their best commanders, Paulie Njovu, and some two went over, were taken out of action, and other we found the dead bodies after some 2 days.
Walusimbi applauded the community for being cooperative and urged them to remain vigilant in the fight against the wrong elements in their region.
But I thank the community for being vigilant and they easily cooperated with us. That's why you have at least have them breathing space. And for us, we are very ready and we are in charge.
He reassured the public that Kasese District is safe for people to visit and peacefully enjoy their festive season.
Because of alarm in Kasese, people should come and enjoy their Christmas and the New Year in Kasese. We have peace. People should not threaten you not to come to Kasese. No. People do think in Kasese that people almost don't move, but people move up morning.
Kasese District leadership, in conjunction with the non-governmental initiatives, are offering psychosocial support to the bereaved families, according to Elifaz Imuhindo, the Kasese District LC5 chairperson.
We have kept on counseling those who were traumatized. You know, when you lose your dear ones as a result of what happened, people get traumatized. So we have our parasocial workers who are moving to these families and counsel them.
Report compiled by Samuel Amanyire for the news.